Please, just... I need to be alone right now.
Sturgis.
Now this place is starting to feel like home. Now that we can grow our own food, I think we can really make a go of this. Trouble is, the more we establish ourselves here, the more of a target we become. What we need is to get some defenses set up. Then maybe Preston will be able to relax a little bit.
What sort of defenses did you have in mind?
Walls, sandbags, turrets, whatever you can put together.
Hey, Sturgis.
Thanks for doing that. We'll all sleep better at night knowing we have some defenses set up. It's been a long road. But yeah, I think this is it. Home. Feels good.
What next?
Well, I guess figuring out how to get back to living instead of just surviving. Of course, you know you're welcome anytime. My door's always open to you. Windows, too. Some of the walls, actually, come to think of it. I guess I better get back to it. Take care now.
Stay sharp. Don't let your guard down.
Huh? So what's your story? Looking to trade? Rob me? Or just ask directions to Diamond City?
Diamond City? Where's that?
Directions. Figures. Just keep going until you see the skyline. Cross the river. You'll find the Great Green Jewel just inside the city limits.
Carla.
Hey there. Trading?
What kind of stuff do you have?
Just a bit of everything. You'd be surprised what people leave behind on the old roads. Gotta keep your eyes peeled for the good stuff. Got plenty to sell if you're interested.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
You break it, you buy it.
We had a deal, Trudy. Hand over the goods. You owe us.
I ain't giving you poison shilling chem pushers anything. Do you know what that junk has done to my boy?
He bought them fair and square, Trudy. Ain't our fault if he's strung out. Now don't make me come in there and shoot up that little trading post of yours. Whoa, easy there, Scabber. This doesn't involve you.
Well, hey there, pup.
You stop waving that gun in my face, or it's gonna involve me.
Okay, just take it easy. We'll lower our weapons, all right? Just don't do anything crazy.
What's going on here?
That's a simple business dispute, got it? Trudy's sitting on a pile of goods that she owes me. I tried reasoning with her, but it looks like I gotta take what's mine by force. Wanna make some easy money? Help me out. I could use another gun. Or maybe you think you can talk some sense into her.
I'll talk to her. Maybe we can work this out.
Appreciate it. If things go sideways, we'll back you up.
Hey there.
I saw you in that poison cellar talking. Well, he ain't getting his money. Period.
Look, you owe them money. If you just pay them, then this'll be over. Everyone walks away without getting hurt.
All right, I'll pay. But that bastard ain't gonna sell one more drop of jet to my boy. You hear that, Wolfgang? You'll get your damn money. But I better not catch you selling chems to my boy again.
Fine by me, Trudy. Your son's broke as shit anyhow.
All right. Crisis is over. If you're here to trade, step up to the counter.
We get paid and I don't even gotta shoot nobody. Good job. Here. Now how about I show you all the pick-me-ups I have to offer?
What kind of chems do you sell, anyway?
Well, whatever I can get a hold of. Jet's popular. Gives you a rush when you need it. Like when you need to hurt somebody. The stim packs are like gold, of course. Everyone's bound to get hurt and need fixing sometime. And I always try to carry Rad away for obvious reasons. Just pick something up. Have a taste. Best way to get to know the product.
Just looking. Excuse me.
I'm the muscle, babe. Just don't piss me off, all right?
Never take a hit at Jet again, I swear.
Hey.
Golly, Chen, just itching all over.
We're open for business again. A little lighter in the pocket, thanks to you. How about you buy something and make it up to us?
You got things covered from here?
Yeah. It's gonna take my son a while to get off the chems, but we'll make it. We always do. Now, let's get back to business. You need anything for the road?
Just browsing for now. Hey. Wait there. Hey. Come on.
whoa. Easy there, Scabber. This doesn't involve you.
You stop waving that gun in my face, or it's gonna involve me.
Okay, okay, just take it easy. We'll lower...
Blah, blah, blah.
What's going on here?
It's a simple business. I tried reasoning with
you.
Wanna make some easy money?
Who's Trudy?
See that diner right in front of us? Trudy owns the place. She's converted it into a small shop. I sell her chems, she gives me caps and parts I need. And when her son Patrick had his 18th birthday, I might have sold him some jet, then some more, then a lot more. Now he's in debt.
Jet? What's jet?
That's my top seller. Gives you a high like you wouldn't believe. My customers swear it makes him faster. Always take off before a fight. Well, I guess Patrick was looking to get from under his mama's skirt and be like the tough guys. So, he bought some. And once you're on it, why stop? Now, I've sold that boy a lot of my jet, and I expect someone to make good on his promises that I get paid.
Looks to me like they shouldn't have bought that jet, and you shouldn't have sold it to them.
Yeah, well, hindsight's a bitch. And I'm holding the leash. Now, you gonna help us out, or what?
If I help, I expect to get paid.
All right. I was gonna pay you 100 caps, but why don't we make it 125?
Sounds low. You're a businessman, right? You can do better.
Okay, okay. 150 caps.
And why would I help you exactly?
Look, I deal in chems. You know, medicine. Kind of useful out in these parts. Stim packs can patch up your wounds in seconds. Not to mention all the fun stuff. I got that too. You help me out and we can do business. Trust me, I'm a good friend to have.
I'll talk to her. Maybe we can work this out.
Appreciate it. If things go sideways, we'll back you up.
Hey.
I saw you in that poison cellar talking. Well, he ain't getting his money. Period.
Look, you owe the money. If you just pay...
All right. You hear that, Wolfgang? You'll get your damn money, but I better not catch you selling chems to my boy again.
Fine by me, Trudy. Your son's broke as shit anyhow.
All right. Crisis is over. If you're here to trade, step up to the counter.
We get paid, and I don't even gotta shoot nobody. Good job. Here. Now how about I show you all the pick-me-ups I have to offer?
Let me think it over.
I've been thinking about this for a long, long time. I know what I'm talking about here.
Bullshit. You can't just put something between two pieces of bread and claim it's a sandwich. Does that mean a loaf of bread is technically a bread sandwich?
Technically, yes, but you wouldn't eat it all at once like that, so it doesn't matter. How you hold it matters.
Talk all you want. You put that piece of my alert meat between two pieces of bread, but it still ain't a sandwich.
Well, what the hell would you call it then?
Disgusting. That's what.
Hi.
Huh?
Excuse me.
Huh?
Hi.
Yeah?
Hey.
Huh? Yeah? Huh?
Excuse me.
Hi, how are you?
Security's too good.
Thank you. describe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARX, Ferrum, 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties. We're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station. Automated message repeating. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARX, Ferrum, 9-5.
Thank you.
Got it. Won't be able to pick this. Thank you.
We appreciate the assistance, civilian. What's your business here?
Before I answer, will you tell me who you are?
In due time. If you want to remain in our compound, I suggest you answer my question first.
I'm just trying to survive out here, like everyone else.
The way you charged in and engaged those ferals, I find that a bit difficult to believe. Are you from a local settlement?
Do all these questions really matter? After all, I help you fight those ferals.
You make a fair point. If I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
That all depends. How much are you paying?
We need allies, not opportunistic mercenaries. I have no inclination to pay for your services.
I want to help, but I don't like the secrecy. Who are you, really?
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. We're on recon duty, but I'm down a man and our supplies are running low. I've been trying to send a distress call to my superiors, but the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need. The deep range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? You willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
Who are the Brotherhood of Steel?
Our order seeks to understand the nature of technology, its power, its meaning to us as humans. And we fight to secure that power from those who would abuse it.
Your cause seems noble.
I'm pleased that you agree. There are very few, outside the Brotherhood, who appreciate the gravity of the situation we're facing as a species. So, what do you say? Will you help us?
No time to waste. Let's get moving.
Outstanding. Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Yes, sir.
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
I'm on it.
All right, civilian. It's time to prove your worth. Head into the police station and resupply yourself. Then let me know when you're ready to begin. Let's move out, people.
All right, big guy. Let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Halen?
You better get a move on. It's not a good idea to keep Paladin Dance waiting.